My love of science grew really as a kid. My mum had a pretty traumatic life, and you know, she pretty much raised my sister and I on her own till my stepdad came along, and we didn't have a lot, so I found joy in animals and reptiles. And my first book was Reptiles in Colour by Harold Cogger, and it was 1989, and it was from an op shop, and it had another little boy's signature in it. And I learnt every single page. I still remember page 6 is Eastern Water Dragons, and you know they can hold their breath underwater for an hour. I was often told that I couldn't do things, and I left school at 16, and I went to Western Australia and I worked in a wildlife sanctuary. And then I came back and I started working as a zookeeper. And then I saw an ad in the paper for an alpaca shearer, and I started shearing alpacas. And I went around Australia and New Zealand, and I saw a lot of the country, and I saw a lot of the people that I normally wouldn't get access to. And I was always empowered by their stories. I started Deadly Science 3.5 years ago when I started chatting to Indigenous kids in Redfern, and we would talk to them and would ask them, you know, we'd look at the sky and we'd say, you know, there's a space station up there and there's astronauts. And they'll go, no way, that's not even like possible. And you'd show them a photo. And then it's like, well, how do they have water up there? Or how do they have oxygen up there? And then those questions just flow on. And then you take it back and you tie it back to our history. 65,000 years of science, the way we manage the animals, the fish traps, the astronomy. It's all in Bruce Pascoe's book, Dark Emu, and Australia's First Naturalist by Lynette Russell. Those lessons I was tying back into the science and the magic, and I saw how intrigued they were and how the magic of science was opening up their eyes to a new world. So I went home and I Googled most remote school in Australia, because I felt that if these kids in the city were so intrigued, that the kids in the bush and the remote areas would be even more crazy about science. So I rang up a school and I found out a school only had 15 books in it. And then I realised how greatly under-resourced these remote schools were, and I had to do something about it. There was no option. So I packed up all the books I owned and I sent them out there. And now almost 18 months later, we've sent 5,000 books, 90 telescopes, smart gardens, stuff that's just gonna spark the mind. Every kid should have the ability to believe in themselves and experience the magic that is science.